welcome to part two of how God kept his promise to Paul. Now, we left the story at how Paul was on a ship as a prisoner and he was set sail to Rome, and they were caught in a terrible storm. And it had been days and they had to throw cargo off the ship just to survive. And for days, the sun didn't shine, the waves and rain didn't stop, and the ship kept lurching back and forth. The sailors, guards, and prisoners lost all hope of surviving. They were so worried that they stopped eating. Paul stood up and said, "You should have listened to me and not set sail. But I can tell you that none of us will die, though the ship will be lost. Last night, an angel of the Lord came to me and told me that no one on the ship will die, and I will appear before Caesar as God promised I would." Paul trusted God would get him to Rome, just like he promised. Paul encouraged the other men on the ship by telling them that God would save all 276 of them, though the ship would crash on an island. Isn't that so amazing that God wouldn't just save maybe 200 or maybe 50, but he was very exact, all 276, and it says in the Bible. The men probably were relieved to know that they weren't going to die, but the storm still didn't stop. It had been 14 days, that's 2 weeks since the storm started. But on the 14th night, the sailors suspected they were close to land. They checked and land was near. But some of the sailors got so impatient and they tried to sneak away from the ship in a smaller boat. Paul knew this and told the centurion and the soldiers, "The only way these men will be saved is if they stay on the ship." So they cut the small boat away and let it go into the ocean. Paul encouraged everyone to eat something. He said, "You haven't eaten in 14 days. You will need your strength. God will save us." Paul took some bread and thanked God for it. So he prayed. The rest of the men also ate and they were encouraged. Then they lightened the ship one more time, meaning they had to throw things overboard. When the day came, they saw land. They could be safe. They tried to direct the ship to the land, but it struck a reef, which are rocks or like sand just below the surface of the water. And they crashed. The ship began to break apart on the reef. Time was running out for the ship. The soldiers wanted to kill all the prisoners so they couldn't escape, but the centurion ordered them not to because he wanted to save Paul's life. The centurion ordered, "Everyone who can swim, jump overboard and swim to shore. But if you can't swim, grab a plank and save yourself that way." The people did what the centurion said, and all 276 people on the ship made it safely to shore. God kept his promise to keep all of them safe. They learned they were on the island of Malta. The people welcomed them and took care of their needs. Paul told the people of Malta about Jesus, and God used Paul to heal those people who were sick. Finally, after 3 more months, Paul was able to get on another ship. God kept his promise, and Paul arrived in Rome, finally! In Rome, Paul was still a prisoner, but God used him to tell many people about Jesus while he was there. God kept his promise to Paul just as he said he would. God keeps his promises with you too. Remember, God can be trusted to keep his promises. If you believe in Jesus, then as you read God's word each day, you can look for promises that tell about who God is and what he will do in your life. When you feel hopeless and confused or wonder if God is working in your life, read his word and remember he is faithful to keep his promises. Say it with me. Trust God. He keeps his promises. Will you trust God to always keep his promises? As you spend time reading God's word this week, you can look for those promises from God in the Bible. Try writing them down and bring them with you to share with your families or friends. So, as you reflect on this story, remember to be obedient, just like how Paul was, to God's instructions, and always trust that God keeps his promises.